coming your way exclusively on pay-per-view. And if you've been with us the last few weeks, Chicago, Denver, you've seen what's been going on between the Giant and Hulk Hogan. Well, last week, the Giant and the Taskmaster were banned from the building by a restraining order. No one could get a restraining order this week. They are going to be here. We're going to hear from Hulk Hogan.
It's going to be a big night, Mongo. I want to talk about that last match. Bockwinkle's got to levy some fines. That's all there is to it.
Fines don't mean nothing to that man. That man's got $13 million. But I wouldn't be surprised if the Giant drives that monster truck right in through this building, right
don't
in through the walls
it.
Of this place.
He almost did it last week. Our next matchup, the great Eddie Guerrero taking on Chris Benoit in his debut. And you heard Chris Benoit say it when we saw him last week live from Chicago. He said, hey, this is where the big boys play. And he is here, and he's taking on a real tough, real fast, real experienced Eddie Guerrero. This is going to be a classic matchup, Mongo.
What did they call this guy up north, the Canadian crippler?
That's right. The man's from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. The man has put more people on the shelf. He said he's not coming north. He's not coming south for the season. He's coming here for a reason. He wants competition, and he wants the best here at WCW.
Conable hookup into a side headlock by Eddie Guerrero. He's got a wide base. Benoit, probably the stronger of the two, takes him into the corner. Guerrero coming off the ring ropes with some great velocity. Takes Benoit to the mat. Up and over. Guerrero so quick. Benoit puts on the brakes. Nice duck under into a reverse hammerlock. 1-2 count. I'll tell you what, these guys are quick. Excuse me, reverse wrist lock.
Let me tell you, you can already tell these guys are two technicians. What athletes. Unbelievable.
Oh!
Head scissors takeover. Guerrero. Benoit taken down. I'll tell you what, the action so fast when these two athletes get in, and Guerrero gets hooked up in the ropes. Guerrero gets hooked up in ropes, and in case you just joined us, the Giant will be here with Taskmaster.
No!
Flying cross body block off the top rope. Well, Eddie Guerrero on Chris Benoit, and Hulk Hogan, the world champion, will be here without his mustache, and I dare say without his pride, without his dignity, but with a whole lot of anger built up inside.
But he's got one thing going for him, Bischoff. He's got a neck brace on, because the Giant tried to unscrew his head.
Let me tell you one thing, Mr. Stain. If you don't think Hogan's going to rise to the occasion at Halloween Havoc, you got more rocks in your head than a face up at Mount Rushmore.
Oh!
Tremendous combination of moves. It started out with a standing switch by Eddie Guerrero, converted to a side headlock. Reversed into a side. Looked like he was going to try to take him over the side suplex, but that was reversed. Both men out over the top rope. And now it's Benoit, face first, into the post, and in a wicked, wicked forearm to the back of the head, and it looks like Guerrero wrapped his hand right into that ring post, and he did. Guerrero is hurt.
I don't think he got him good with that forearm in the back of the head. I think he got most of it with the post.
No, he hit that forearm wrapped around his head, and he hit his, I saw clearly, you could hear it, he hit his hand on that post, and he is hurt.
Something snapped, and I hope it wasn't bone.
And now, Chris Benoit.
Look at the agility of that man.
He is so strong, Mongo. He's got explosive power.
Well, a guy of that size, with that kind of strength, you're going to snap guys around like they're paperweights.
Well, that's why they call him the Canadian Crippler. There's one man right now, Eddie Guerrero. He's got a bad wing, and it's not going to get any better.
That wasn't no fault of his.
Well, it wasn't my fault. Of course it was his fault.
I'm surprised the referee hasn't checked that elbow. I mean, or the arm, the elbow of Eddie Guerrero. He is hurt. Benoit taking every advantage of it. He is just picking Guerrero apart now, picking his shots, and now he's going to go into a hammerlock body slam. Oh, no, he's up and over with that hammerlock.
If it wasn't broke before, it's broke now.
Speed and a boot to the head. You saw clearly great work by our cameraman, our director, Craig Leathers, in the truck. You saw it front and center in your face.
Is he in the truck or under the truck this week?
Suplex.
I'll tell you something about this Benoit. He's a major star all over the world, internationally, in Europe, in Japan. The man's held many titles.
This reminder, Mike Tenay on the WCW Hotline, 1-909-9900. Kids, get your parents' permission. He has got some hot, I mean double hot, information for you if you want to know what's going on, not only tonight around the world in professional wrestling, but any other time, call the hotline. And now, Eddie Guerrero. Off the middle rope. Tremendous move by Eddie Guerrero.
He's out.
Guerrero, bad arm and all. He is in control. He is fighting through the pain, Mongo.
Just what I told you earlier in the show, baby. You're going to see some wrestling moves that have never been seen on this planet before. And if you've ever seen that move before, you got rocks in your head like Heenan.
Well, that was a desperation move. He's wrestling with one arm. He's only got one wing going for him.
Oh, short clothesline.
See the velocity the way he took that man down, Eddie Guerrero?
Every move Benoit makes is crisp, strong, and accurate. This guy has no wasted motion, Mongo.
You've got to say crippling. He is aptly named.
And the lock reverse. Eddie Guerrero, 1-2, and an escape.
But he's still favoring that arm. Oh, arm's damaged.
He's in big trouble. He wrapped that arm around that ring post, and I don't know if it's the elbow joint or the forearm itself, but he's in trouble.
It doesn't matter. Arms and arm.
Look at him, though. He's still out there giving it 110%. I promise you, a football player would already be on the sidelines with a replacement in.
And his agent would be calling, negotiating next year's contract.
Ooh. Ooh.
Chops right across the top of the chest. Stinging chops. And now, Guerrero, gamely fighting back. But you could do, I mean,
listen to that.
Man, it is like a rifle report out there. You can hear it all the way across the arena. And we are coming to you live. The only live action tonight if you're into wrestling. Stay with us. The World Heavyweight Champion is here. The Giant is here. Lethal combination of personalities anytime you have these two in the same building. We've seen it the last couple of weeks.
And I'll tell you something I noticed about a half hour ago. Ric Flair has his own dressing room, and so does Sting.
Yeah.
If they're going to be partners tonight, why wouldn't they be sharing a dressing room?
Absolutely, Mongo. We talked about it. This is not a match made in heaven by any stretch of the imagination.
Well, I think Mr. Sting still has some reservations. We're going to have to see how that turns out.
You'll find out later on tonight. Ric Flair and Sting. Yes, you have heard us right. Ric Flair and Sting in the main event to take on Arn Anderson and Brian Pillman. I want to take this opportunity while Benoit is just torturing Eddie Guerrero to congratulate our own Atlanta Braves. They are in the World Series tomorrow night. We'll find out whether it's Seattle or Cleveland. They're going to defeat to become the World Series champions. My prediction, Mark.
Well, that would be a beautiful thing.
Look at this. Look at
that. Like balance. And agility.
That was a beautiful thing.
Call that one, Bishop. I don't know what you'd call that
move. Off the top rope. Head scissors. Benoit does the only thing he can do. And that's draping ankle. I'll tell you what. That had to catch Benoit by surprise. Side suplex. Oh. And now it is Benoit who's getting tossed around like a rag doll.
But look at Eddie Guerrero. He's not getting up yet. He is still favoring that arm. There's no way he can win this match with one arm.
Well,
you can't beat Benoit with one
arm. I beg to differ. Guerrero definitely in control of this contest. While the pace is slowed down, the punishment remains the same as these guys are hammering each other with high-impact offense.
Look at this action. You know, if you're not a WCW fan after watching this, you're dumber than dirt.
I'll tell you what. The C in WCW stands for commitment. Commitment to bring you the biggest names in our industry, the most exciting young stars in our industry, and the best wrestling action live every week here on Nitro.
Well, that C also stands for crippled, and that's where Eddie Guerrero is right now. He is crippled.
Guerrero probably favoring his ribs and his arm at this point. Did you see that? Guerrero's head bounced off the mat like a basketball.
And he still kicked out of it.
I thought Dennis Rodman was going to rebound his head.
Oh, man. Woo-hoo. That would change the color of your hair, wouldn't it?
Change the color of your shorts.
Oh, my. Guerrero dazed. He is in trouble, and he's going again. No, it's reversed. He reverses it. Oh, he used the same right hand that he hurt earlier on. Full Nelson. Full Nelson belly to back suplex.
Oh.
Benoit sticks Guerrero. But it was after Guerrero. He wasn't thinking straight, Mongo. He reached back, called off Colcock. Benoit with a hand that wrapped around the ring post.
Oh, Eddie, somebody better go get a neck brace for him.